and keyboard, otherwise it will mess up your camera. Other than that, I'd say we're ready to go. So, standard procedure for the run is to make a new save, and then time would start as soon as I clicked begin game. You can skip pretty much every single cutscene in this, and for this first little switch I just count to 2, and that's usually enough time for me to get a close and precise ending to get through that door. Now, I go on this switch, and see, I'll wait about this long to go through it. I can't really show it off well, but the top of Wilbur's hair, and then the next line above that, is where I wait for the door to go. So once I see that the door is there, I just go straight through here. Now, you can either go straight forward, and this will bring up a dialogue box, or you can go a little bit to the right, and that will skip the dialogue box, which saves like half a second. So always do that. When I'm around the section, I just hold straight forward, and I press space to skip this cutscene right away. Now, you'll notice that you can either get on a ladder like this, or you can just very slightly adjust your camera and get on from about here. Since ladders have a really large hitbox, so that's a bit more optimal. And then again, press space going up this ladder. Then you want to rotate your camera as you move along so you don't get stuck. Like, if I don't rotate my camera, sometimes Wilbur will get stuck and almost like jump backwards, and that loses some frames. Because optimally you want to get out of here with a 213, 212. And for sliding, it's pretty simple. You just press space when you expect it to come up and hold it. Now, this is annoying, but I'm going to show it off if I can. And I can't, apparently. Okay, I think I got it. So, if you get the animation like I just got, you'll just fall straight down, you'll lose the run. It's pretty easily avoidable, and I'm gonna show off how to do that in just a few seconds. Since it loses about 30 seconds, it's definitely best to avoid it and just to straight up reset over it, since it's only like a minute and 30 seconds into a typical run. Honestly, most of the time in this level, like once you have it memorized, you're just going to be pressing space. So you just go to the outside like this and you'll avoid that. I'm not really sure there's a best angle to go at this from. I guess the closer to the left wall, the better. Now you're going to start holding your grab button, which mine is R. So I'm holding my grab button so that I can push the statue in the next room. Now for this door, the visual cue is pretty simple. Again, you see this next like dim line above Wilbur's stupid haircut. You want to wait until it's like just like a pixel or two above that, like so, and then you just walk through. So now that I'm holding R, I can just turn Wilbur into here and he'll grab it. And as for how far you want to push the statue, I go to this line right here. Like the beginning of the curl, like the hieroglyph, I guess. And as you see, this is what happens when you just hold straight space on a jump. Sometimes you just want to let go in the middle, like, or not space. So, like if you hold, sometimes if you hold forward too long during a jump, you'll get some weird animations and lose time. What you want to do is just let go in the middle of the jump and then hold it again. The important thing for this section is just your camera. You want to start mashing space around here, or whatever you use to skip cutscenes, and have your finger on the back button, whatever you decide to use. And this is pretty simple, you just run straight forward and you just want to keep pressing space to skip the cutscenes right away. And then you want to press right click, or space and right click right away to get out of this menu as soon as possible.
There you are. Have you taken out the garbage yet?
No, but I'm dying to do it.
So, there is a skip coming up in a few minutes. Garage skip or garage early, if you prefer. I am not going to be showing the alternative to do that, because I think it's completely unnecessary. With the setup I use, it's easy enough to do. So you just want to do space right right click there, and you want to head straight out to the yard. And you can just start pressing space whenever to open the door. which should show up on my input display. And I just keep on pressing space throughout this whole segment. I start rotating the camera around this bend to get a good angle on the maze. So the maze, or the maze, the ball course movement's interesting. So whenever you're not holding on a turn, once you're in like the height, I guess, of your turn, like you want to hold one direction until you about round the corner for a turn, and then you want to hold your second direction to gain some extra speed. Because if you hold two directions in your turn, it's slower than not holding two directions. For some reason, I don't know how to explain it, I would just say look at my input this way. It's already one direction, two directions. So right, upright, right, upright, like that's what I mean, right, upright for the turns. So obviously, this is pretty self-explanatory, you want to hit the boosts. You want to try to avoid these as best as possible. If you make like a good cycle, you just won't have to worry about that, which is why I just instinctively just go for the good cycle. And I'm just holding up left here. Again, like banging into anything loses several seconds. So you want to hold upright as soon as you hit that boost. That's pretty important. That saves some, like, half a second, I would say. And then up left and turn the camera here to hit this boost. And then upright and turn the camera here. So I'd say I lost like 4 seconds in the maze. And you want to take these corners as tight as possible. And you will fall playing things like this. I let go here in order to sacrifice some speed for some accuracy. So you want to be getting a 133 in the maze. Then you teleport to Wilbur's room. And you go out this door. Go to the right. Open the door. You want to start pressing space. And you want to go up and talk to Laszlo, who can spawn in a number of places. That's RNG as far as I know. So right now we're going to be getting the disassembler and the scanner, which are two pretty useful things in the run. So what we're going to be doing is collecting components after we get the scanner in order to build the disassembler, which is what he's explaining right now. And we want to mash space as soon as we get in here, just skip a cutscene and then go up the ladder. Alternatively, you could try to get the disassembler through under it. Like, you can go under that panel right there that I'm looking at and get the disassembler, but it's really finicky on PC and not worth it. Okay, so as soon as you get to here, you want to move your finger over escape. I don't have it in my input display, but ready, you just press escape. And this skips a prompt and a few other things. Then you disassemble this with a quick target, which is E. Then you go up here, Q, quick, alternative target, wait a second. And then you go over here, quick target, no target, go down the ladder. And that's all the components you'll need for the run. I usually do that. You want to round about here. You want to line yourself up right about here, press space, space, wait, and it's very important you don't press space here. You want to press escape. It skips the 20 second to 30 second cutscene, and then you want to, I guess I'll explain this really quick. So you press E, don't lock on to anything, and the reason I'm doing this is because this is your max speed right here, what I'm doing right now. So you want to hold space, hold right, and you want to roll until you get to the door, then you hold down, space, hold space, mash F1 or whatever button you use for your guide button. I turn around once I get that prompt, and then I get about here, turn my camera, and scan that. Now, you can do another trick here, which I'm not gonna go over, because it doesn't save time, so just forget I said anything. Then you wanna get Wilbur to about right here, E. And hold space again to the right, let go here, open the door, and mash space. So
I need the code to the garage.
I am going to show off two different things here, which is actually kind of important because it can lose you like 2 seconds that you don't need to lose.
My brain's all a fluster. Find my teeth, and
so
then we'll
that'll take a bit of time.
Meanwhile, I'll search the peanut butter.
Right. I'll go check the music room.
Okay. So you would do this, right? Move your normal way, and you go into the music room. But as you can see, there's a frog missing if you know the run at all. So why is the frog missing? Well, it's because if you go here, like if you go into the room closer and spawn them, a frog, like if you're a certain distance away from the door, the last frog won't spawn for some reason. So I'm just going to show the movement that will spawn him, hence why I'm going in the teleporter to reset the room. Hopefully that resets the room. So what you want to do is actually walk to here and do a few rolls, and that would normally spawn the frog, but since I already did that. And then you just want to do some quick scans here. You can move your scan while you're scanning, which is really helpful. And then you just scan this frog. Wrong frog. You scan this frog and just mash space. Not really mash space, just press it. You want to turn your camera here. I choose not to do the target movement here because I think it's too short of a segment. Then, you know, space to talk to Grandpa. So next we're going to be going into that teleporter and talking to Uncle Art, which is why we activated the teleporter from earlier, to save the movement from going all the way back from here into the living room, into the yard. So we just want to hold straight forward after, well, during that cutscene, and then you go up, up, space, then you go back left and mash space. Wilbur, you're just the boy. This is the last cutscene heavy section of the game, which is nice. It's only like 10 minutes in. We're in the midst of a crisis. So we're about to do Garage Skip, probably the second hardest trick in the run. Maybe the third now. I had a bunch of them on my ship, but now they've escaped. Wilbur Robinson is on the job. Any hint on how to capture them? Yes, a high energy. I don't think there's any reason to not do Garage Skip. You know, like from that charge ball game you're always playing. Great. I'll just go get my charge. So that's why I'm not going to bother with it. Nephew, go get him. So you want to just hold straight back, down, space. Then you want to actually. So once you get in here, what you want to do is space, and you want to roll like that and hold down. Something I haven't included in my runs. So as soon as you see this menu, escape, up, space, space, smash space. Now we're going to the garage. Once you get out of the store, target, run to here, press Q to bring up your alternative targeting. Okay, so this is Garage Skip. So on PC, because this is a PC guide, what you want to do is walk into this corner, and once Wilbur has this animation, you want to move your camera like so, so that it looks exactly like this. You want the edge of your camera to be lined up like this, straight on. And then if you hold right and did it correctly, you'll vault over this small piece of collision. You want to hold it for about 1, 2, 3. A little bit shorter than that, so like 1, 2, 3-ish. I think I'm like a few steps off, so you just tap one more time. And I got it first try, which I actually didn't want to do. But that's actually getting the trick. I wish I could do that in runs, to be honest. But that's as easy as the trick is. So 1, 2, 3, tap, just, so 1, 2, 3. I think I'm in the good position. So you press Q, and then you hold right. Now, this is a frame perfect trick. So what you're gonna wanna do is go over this ledge, and as you're going over the ledge, at a certain point, this is kinda something you'll have to get over time. But you press left click or right click, whichever piece of equipment you have out, which would be left click in this situation. Then you will go through the wall and skip 5 minutes of the game. And I will tell you the mistakes that you could potentially make on this. So, ready? Left click. If you left click and press right, like that, that would mean that you pressed it too early. If you see the targeting system, that means you pressed it too early. So what I did there is I didn't hold right for long enough, so I lost the angle. Now if you go over this and see, so that was too early and I had a bit of a bad angle. So ready? So that was too early again. I think I'm also getting a bad camera angle. So when I do that, that means I pressed left click too late, but I still went over. So now we want to try to get a good angle on this. Which, now this is going to take me a while to get. Because I got it first try, so naturally I won't get it again for a while. So the next section is the basement. And what we're going to be doing in there is a lot of fighting and very little tricks. Probably the most boring section of the run. So, but as you can see, the setup is really consistent. I haven't missed the vault once, which is kind of the hardest part of the trick, in my opinion. The rest is just down to practice. Ideally, you want to line up this trick so that you only have to tap right once and you'll jump over. That makes the trick the easiest it could be, which is kind of what I'm relying on here. So that's why I'm stopping. Like, you can go continuously and try to get the trick like this, but I don't find that very reliable. Sorry about this. Okay, so I got it. See, so that's ideally what you want to do, and you want to walk right about here, and you'll get a cutscene, space, space, alternative target, right click, go down here, alternative target, you want to go a little bit more to the right, alternative target that, charge up your energy. That's one of the most important components of the run, is managing your energy. It lets you kill enemies quicker, and it lets you do other things as well. So I usually go here and target, and then hold right in space. E here, walk up onto this, do that. And you just go forward like normal here. You want to start pressing space here. Press E here, right, and then shoot him. He went too far away, that's bad RNG, so we're just gonna go down, let this trigger, and just mass space. Shoot him once, target, shoot him three times. Set up for our next piece of movement. Okay, if I went any earlier than I did there, I would have been shocked. So now, this is pretty cool. Alternative target, and then you want to cue that really quick. Let's save some time. And we're just right now waiting for somebody to come out of this door, and we go up the elevator. What you want to do here is press E as soon as you get out of the elevator, and let go of E. A vault over here, walk a little bit forward, press E, hold right, and then right click as soon as possible, and then you just hold forward and slide along this. Sorry if I'm going a bit fast, but I feel like these things don't need that much exclamation, it's just simple movement. And you can play the YouTube video on like half speed. So right here, what you want to do is you want to rotate right click, or E right click, then you go here and you want to target about here. Right, target that. Then as you're falling, press left click in order to deal with this robot. Then I press E here, target 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to be a certain distance away, which is why I missed the shot. Then as soon as this activates, left click. Do your movement here, destroy that. Then you want to Q, lock onto both of these guys, which you just hover over them and let go of the mouse button. That makes this fight a lot quicker. You want to charge this up for a later section. Actually, you don't want to do that. It's just a habit I've gotten into. Okay, so this is cool. Usually you right click here, left click, and you just go to where I went and climb the ladder early, because it's solid as soon as you hit the switch. Then we want to right click there and target where I did and left. Target, shoot, go up the invisible ladder. We climb up this ladder, we want to go off to the right and just walk past this guy. And then when we get to right here, we target and hold right. This is very deliberate. I kind of messed it up, but if you do it right, you'll just head straight through here and won't get stuck at all. So now that we have full charge, we can right click this, target right click, target right click, target right click. to get all three of these really quickly. You want to move to about where I am when targeting these next two things. Otherwise, it won't hit the second thing. You'll be kind of screwed. Go to where that line is and do your quick movement. Space a few times. Charge up your energy here. And then you just want to spam right-click for this section mostly. So we right-click here. You want to jump over here. We're going to press Q now. Or not now. Now. So you want to target this, then jump. And then target there and fall. Press space here. And we're just... And the reason we did that is to save some time on the enemies coming out and spawning. So as soon as you get down here, you want to press E. So E, and then you want to find where the enemies are. In order to kill them both, you press Q here, lock onto both of them, and that's that fight. Really simple and quick. So there's a charge thing right near us, so that means we're charging up our energy again. You want to press E like this, and roll out until you get to about here. Press Q. Do that. Move a little bit to the outside, and then right, and then left click for the switch. Then you want to target that. Ideally, you skip that cutscene I just skipped entirely. It's not really a big deal. So once you get to about this sign, you want to target and hold right until about when you see this thing. Then you turn around, press E, and press left click. This section's pretty simple. All you do is cut some corners and go around. You wait for this to come, target, and shoot that. You have to wait until about where I am to do what I'm doing with the alternative targeting, or you will be flung off. And then you'll have one more charge left. You'll use that to activate this a bit early. This is the first and only trick in the basement. And for safety measures, just charge up about this much for later. So this is called an object redirect. What you do is you bring up your alternative menu. And the other trick we did with Garage Skip was a vault redirect. So what you want to do here is your grab button. So grab, and then you would do left click in my situation. So grab right click. That moves the object. This is faster than pushing the object, but it is also frame perfect to my knowledge. Maybe two frames. So you want to object redirect this to the wall. So as you can see now, I'm missing it a few times. Once you get it about here, you go behind it and do one more redirect. If I can do it, that'd be amazing. It's important you do a redirect and not a jump here. So what this does is it skips like a 30 second fight. So it's pretty useful. So right here, I'm just gonna go out here, activate this, press space, untarget. Get here, and then if you have a good angle, you can just quick movement all the way over here. Alright, so now what I'm going to do here is right click, and then I'm going to do that in order to solve this room early. Do your quick movement, let go there, charge until you're about here. Then when you're like right here, I usually just do some quick movement. You want to target that. You want to target those sentinels right away because they take one less hit if you kill them before they spawn their enemy. And right here, you have to disassemble and then five shots into these guys. So we just did that really quick. You get to here, target, move right, then target, left click, target, left click. Go over to the one you kill first, right click, left, right click, target, try to hit them both, target, kill them. On half a heart, I'm at risk of having to start the section over. Same deal here. This is basically a recycled fight. They want to move a bit, target both of them. Alternative target the further one, and this is important. So the sooner you get here, the farther away or the closer the loading zone is to you. I didn't get a good opportunity to show it off there, But if you're far away from that door on the fight, you'll have to go in through it and wait for it to open, so that saves a few seconds. So right here, we want to go left into here and charge our energy up again. And I usually go to where these dots are, target and just hold right. This will get you past the laser room with ease. And then you want to hold right while targeted and open that door. Recharge a little bit if you want. And then you want to roll just to save some time. So I had a bad segment there, so I did not. I did not get to do what I wanted to do. I'm actually just ignoring these guys for now because the sentinels will heal them up. So once you kill these guys, you want to triple target them like that. And that's it for that section. So you want to triple alternative target them because it's more powerful. And it's quicker in most scenarios, and you can target from further. So we're doing the same here. I go on the tube here, because what this will do is skip some movement, and I can just mash space here. So when as soon as these spawn, you just get sucked up, and that saves some time. And the reason that saves time is because that thing I targeted that activated the cutscene, just really quick, again, same place, same thing. This time it's a bit harder because you have to avoid a thing spawning, but it's the same idea. I'll explain. So you want to do the same thing here again. You want to try to get over here as quick as possible. Right. These are your biggest threat, so I usually get rid of these first. I accidentally messed that up, but you want to disassemble them both, you know, double target them and all that. So now, the reason I go over here is, as you can see, this takes time to spawn. You can't target it until you see that red light, so it doesn't really matter what you do. Then you just want to hold straight forward here, press space a few times. Now the strat for this is what I do. I target here, right? Fire right, line up myself with here, target, and go about here. And then as soon as you see electricity run out, press the target button, or press the fire button and E, and then you target right, and then that. So this boss is stupid because you can't use the alternative targeting and lock onto all three of these at once and end each phase right away. So you have to do this one at a time and it takes a while. So, as long as you copy what I do here, you'll have a pretty quick boss fight every time. One thing to note is, the laser's easy to avoid, you can outrun it. He might have another attack, which is those missiles he was just about to shoot. And I'll explain those when he fires them at me if he does. If he doesn't, I'll explain it in the last phase. So as you can see, this is the same shit three times in a row because there are three phases to this fight. We're just going across again. The thing is, if you execute this fight well, you'll never get his other attack. So basically what it is, it's rockets, and if you see him shoot the rockets, just serpentine. You want to right click here, aim where I'm aiming, right click again, left click the red. See, so now I'm serpentining, otherwise the rockets will hit me. And that gives you an opportunity. Well, it still hit me because I went for the hit on that, which isn't a big deal because I had health to play with. You fire from that edge of that circle, in case you guys didn't notice. I feel like this fight could probably get more optimal in the future. I'm actually not really sure what you could do to make it more optimal. So for now, this is how I do it. And I guess, yeah, this is how you would make it more optimal, is moving like this. It would probably save some time. But it's risky, as you can see. As long as you don't get rockets, it's not risky at all. Because the laser's never gonna hit you. So yeah, if you get killed, you have to start the phase over again. Hence why. Yeah, so I'll have to figure out perfect targeting paths on my own. But for now, this is really all you need to worry about. Okay, this is a bad boss fight, but it doesn't really matter. You just want to press space a few times here, and you're in the science fair. So you see, when you're about in between, or actually when you're about like right here, you line up about here, and then space and hold right. Space and hold right. Once you go through the door, forward. Once you get here, yeah, once you get here, you hold right. And then you want to hold down until you get there, hold right, get to the stairwell, target about here, do that, target again, do this. Then I don't target here, I disassemble this with a good angle. This is probably the most fast-paced segment of the run. So you want to rotate your camera on here so you can fall easier, and then mash space to skip a cutscene. Target here, hold right here, go straight, hold right here. And then let go, space, left, hold space, open this door, target to destroy that bookshelf, and bring it to about here. You wanna get, okay, there you go, get forward, disassemble both of these, mash space, skip a cutscene. Try to avoid those notes, it loses like half a second to grab one. And I think the second note's the only one you can easily avoid without losing time. And you get the movement stuff. So when you get out of here, you actually want to like line up about here, so that way you roll up to the staircase. And like the angles are really important for the movement in this area especially. So just whenever you're down these hallways, just mash space to skip cutscenes. I actually went the wrong way there, which sometimes happens when I'm not paying attention. So what you want to do is when you're leaving this hallway is you want to go here, set up some movement, open this door like so, mash space to get on this windowsill quicker, hold upright to get this cutscene, you know, mash space to skip it, the standard shit. Now what you want to do is go into that hallway I just went into, and then you go like so. You do want an angle like this so that you can grab the key right away. So, if you're really confident in your abilities, you can do this. This is a vault trick to save some time. I don't go for it, just because personally I don't really find it to be worth it. But what you do is you'd go over this, right? And you'd vault. So as you can see, it's really hard to get this consistently, and it only saves like 2 or 3 seconds at most. So that's why I don't go for that. But basically, if you get it, you go through the wall and save a little bit of time. But instead, I just do this. So I'm just gonna show off where you'd wind up. So if you went through that wall, you'd wind up right here, so it saves about that much time. But instead, what you wanna do is hold like this-ish. You know, if you have to adjust your target, that's fine. Then you go up this ladder. Important that you have Q equipped for this. Have an angle to where you're spinning inside. Do this. Go up the ladder. As soon as you get up the ladder, hold the right click and whip over here. Q again. Target that. You want to get a jump like this, which is pretty simple. And you want to wind up about here. Now, in order to do what I just did, you just basically have to line up like right about here and hold straight. It's pretty easy. Then once you get here, E targeting, forward, and drop down. Hold, you know, mash space, get the note, and that's it for the segment really. So now we're out the door. And that's the science fair. Space, space, space. Turn around. Same movement as when you got the scanner. Essentially. This time you don't have to press F1 again. And then I usually get about here and do this. And then E. And then if you do it right, you'll get right to the transit station. So my advice to you is to save when you get to the transit station, which I will be doing because this is a demonstration. Otherwise, your game has a small chance of crashing because it's happened to me a few times on good runs. Anyway, you just go up to this transit station and mash space to get through the cutscenes right away. This is where the run really starts to get challenging and fun. So what I always do is I stretch out my arm, crack my knuckles. These are the pro tips you need. Just because I kind of get jammed up and strained. So, what we're going to be doing here is a lot of fights and a really cool glitch.
Been doing this for years. Family business. Night generation. Total professional.
Double space there, and then if you want to be safe, save here. Right. And then you want to Q, target that guy, get his energy, target him. Get his energy. Target him. Get his energy. Target this last guy. Get his energy. That opens up these doors. What I would do is target him, turn around, target him, target him. The section's a bit confusing, and honestly, I haven't figured out the optimal route for it. But honestly, like, it's important to charge up your energy right here to about this much. Press space here, go up this elevator, and then you want to Q, double target these guys. I missed my double target, which is pretty rare, and then you just want to spam target this guy 3 times. I'm pretty sure what causes this crash is entering the ball course too early, so what I would do is just wait like a second. And you'll crash as soon as you get on that ball course. So what you want to do here is just hold straight forward, and you'll skip part of the maze. It's pretty simple, easy. So our goal here is to not fall off, obviously, and it's pretty easy. Just follow what I do. You know, rotate. Like, right now, I'm just holding left. If you ever think you're gonna fall off, just rotate your camera, and that kills your speed pretty well. So this is kind of tricky, but what I like to do here is this. So see, I'm rotating my camera here to kill my speed, otherwise I might fling off. So once you're falling right here, escape, save, save, down, space, space, load your save, and you spawn here. You want to go backwards into the maze, and then you want to build up some momentum and go up here, like so. Doesn't matter what the camera does here, really. And this is very important. You want to snag this section. And then you want to fall off here. Congratulations, you have walked through walls now. And now what we're doing is heading over to the next section by walking out of bounds, which is not possible in many sections of the game. I think this is actually the only section. So you just want to follow my movement here, roughly. So once you trigger this cutscene, skip it a few spaces. You want to save the game and quit here. And you do this to restore your normal collision, because if you don't, it will just be bad for you in the long run. Okay, he's ready. If you're quick enough, you can triple target these guys. I missed one because I was slow. And what you want to do with these guys is not shoot at them, and you want to push them off the edge. This saves a lot of time and trouble in the long run. This saves you taking a trip to charge your energy, which is very important. You just wait for this guy to spawn here. He spawns in the same place every time. You want to target him. Apparently the first target didn't register, which is whatever. Then you target this guy to get some energy. I target right here. They spawn a bit far out. I hit this guy four times if I don't have the energy. And that's it for this area. Hopefully that made sense. I would watch it over a few times at half speed to see exactly what I do. So, we just want to move like this over to the elevator. Pretty simple shit. And we're about to set up speed storage, which you can only get this in very limited areas. So what you want to do is line up with the M, I think about right here, hold left. This positioning isn't really that important. So basically, you see how I'm targeted like this? You just want to be targeted when you're moving, and then hold the direction and space when you target in the tram system, and then this will happen. So this gives you full speed. For the small segment, and I just hold right here, press E, forward, E, space.
Here is your transit pass. Enjoy your ride on the volcano train.
That's great, but can we settle the bill now? I deal on a cash-only basis.
The check is in the mail.
Rats!
So then you want to go here, press E, and if you have a good angle, you'll go straight this way. Unfortunately, I did not. So you actually want to untarget here, or you'll get something. I'll try to show it off. So if you target and move here, you have a chance of getting something I call a weird spawn. You can skip this cutscene, double space. So I didn't get weird spawn, so I'm not going to explain it unless I mess up. I'm actually going to save right here so I can explain two different paths that you can go. So I'll show off the beginner route first. You would want to get your disassembler, target that. Target that and do this. So as you can see, this is pretty slow, so you might be wondering what the alternative path is, and I'll get into that in a second. As far as I know, you can't get up here any other way than just going around here. So as you can see, this kind of takes a lot of time, so I don't really like it that much. Ideally you would do that. Just pretty much ignore the enemies completely here. I think you can get up like this. Then you try to line up a super jump. I messed up. I haven't done it in a while. This is what you want to line up. You want to go around this, jump here. Get over here, ignore these ants if you can. And then you're over here. Now, what I personally do is something different. So what I do is I aim here, line my camera up here, and this is called a jump redirect, or a climb redirect if you will. What you want to do is, I'm on my charge ball gun, so I want to space and left click at the same time ish. It's again a frame perfect trick, so it might take me a while to get. But doing this saves 30 or 40 seconds doing it first try. So when I have the animation, I just hold forward and I'm out of bounds. So it's pretty simple, that's all you have to do. So if you get this prompt when you're up there. That means you're too early. If you climb, that means you didn't press left click as you pressed space. Pretty simple stuff. So right here, you want to target, hold left. Then you want to untarget and jump over here, walk around, get to about here, fall off and rotate your camera quickly and you'll pop back in bounds, which is important. Get to the edge of this hill-ish. I'd say like right about here? No. Here. Oh wait, no. Okay, so you have to be about here. That's what I was doing wrong. Get over here and hold right. Save some time. Untarget, jump. Now, you want to go here and get your disassembler out. You can charge up if you want. It's not really required. Get this guy's attention. He'll spin towards you. Then you want to use the disassembler on him continuously. This makes this pretty easy. Try to grab some of the momentum that gives you. Mash space there. Go across this. Q. Target. Pretty simple stuff. And then... oops. Target him. Target him. Push this forward. Q. Climb up this. Climb up this. Right click that. Push this down. Then target him. This last guy I'm targeting is irrelevant. Or he's irrelevant after you knock him down. He'll just die as soon as the other two die. And then you want to target this guy here. Like so. Once you get here, let go. Target right here. Escape your target and look for Jacoby. And you press space on him. Take a quick stretch break again. Minute long cutscene. We're about to do a trick called Havoc Gloves Early. Probably the second, the hardest individual clip in the game if you don't know what you're doing. And it can be hard to get the hang of. But the alternative, which I will show off, and I would not recommend doing, because it's just slower. I guess it's a bit easier. Is what I'm about to do. Sorry if this isn't the best in the world, but I'm explaining things as best as I can. So since I'm about to do two different things, I'm just gonna save and demonstrate them. So for this section, if you're doing the slow way or the more beginner-friendly way, you want to go like so. Disassemble this. Skip this cutscene. So as you can see, you can't target this. So what you need to do is you need to redirect this forward, like so. Make sure you can jump on it, so I can't, so I have to grab it and move it a bit outward. Now I can jump on it. Fantastic. So now what we're going to be doing is a redirect climb, which I don't like personally doing because I think they're harder than any other redirect. So actually, let's do it from this side. This side's safer. If I can, anyway. So we want to get here, do our redirect climb. And we're out of bounds here. You want to hold this way and get a good angle. I haven't done this trick in a while, so I'm sorry that I don't remember the perfect angle to get back in bounds. So that's basically what you do. You can walk through these. You want to target this and disassemble the sign, if I recall correctly. And that puts you on the other side here. You want to go down this manhole to skip a cutscene and grab that. And that brings you to this area. Skips a cutscene. And then you talk to this girl. And then you go in there. Alternatively, what you should be doing in my humble opinion, is going back to the industrial district right away after you talk to Jacoby. You press Q, do a now, we're doing a vault redirect. You want your angle to be about here, but this isn't normal to where you can just tap and be fine, because it changes your angle. Like, you can't be, like, lined up, like, right here and do the redirect, because I'll try to show off what happens. So this is the same angle I'll be holding. Just keep that in mind. So it pushes me out because of the thickness of the wall, but if I'm lined up, like, say, here, and I get it, then I'll just go right in. So that's basically the major thing about this trick. That's all you need to know. So if you look back, you'll see, so let's say this is the corner, right? I wasn't lined up right at the corner in vaulting. I was like here and then vaulting. The reason I do that is because the further into the box you are, the more likely you are to stay in it. So as you can see, we're already where we were when we did that other trick. All you want to do is target here and hold right to avoid some enemies spawning. So this is exactly the same as the other thing. You want to line up here. You want to press 1, 2, 3. You want to target all these. And I stood in a very deliberate place because that skips a cutscene. You want to just target here. So just note that. Grab your havoc gloves. You're going to want to press... Actually, you can press escape. Press Q right away, drill. Then you want this to be right click and this to be F. And then you want, ideally you equip everything before you get that cutscene. So there are two ways to do this. So you can either do a trick called dive redirecting, where you get to like the very edge of something and do a frame perfect dive to fall down, which is very hard and not really worth the time it saves in this particular situation. So what I just do is like so. Just do that. Space, 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 space. Back, right. And you just see. So that's the cutscene I was talking about skipping. Press space to get into this. So this is this first of two mazes. As long as you follow my exact movement, you won't have any trouble. And if I do something wrong, I'll point it out. There's not really much to say here. Okay, well there's a little bit to say, so I'll say it. As soon as like as you press space to exit this mage, just hold straight. Whoever you are, won't you help out? Triggers the cutscene a bit quicker. Deprived children. Volcanic rubble has blocked my ice cream shop. Now, what I do here is probably the quickest way. So left click, you know, the usual. You can destroy that through that. And now when you get to right where I am, you want to drill here and go through this, and that's because it skips a prompt. And we're taking this way because it's the way that I found to be most optimal. Mash space here to skip a cutscene. So what you want to do is drill, knock him over, drill again to kill him in one hit. Bam. Bam, bam. Pretty simple stuff here. You want to get in this exact position to get all three of them here. Go under again. Trigger him. I actually made a small mistake here. What I did not do is press this button. So you press the button ideally right away, basically. Then you want to deal with these ants. So since I didn't do this correctly, dealing with them is going to be a bit different than how you would normally, which the normal movement here would be to go over here, kill the first ant, leave the second and third ant and destroy things like how I'm destroying them. And then kill all the ants. And ideally you'd be like right about here so you could talk to the ice cream man right away. So this is the normal way of doing it. I will point out though that there is a way to skip this entire sequence. What you would do to skip this entire sequence is go here, line up in such a way that you vault straight, that's slightly out of bounds. It's pixel perfect, and then you have to do a frame perfect dive redirect to fall down here, and that skips this fighting section. But I haven't found a reliable setup for it yet, so I don't do it. Now when you get down here, you wanna press E and hold left and get in the ball course. So now if you're doing things right, you can make quick cycle, which I don't think I can. No, I missed it. I was playing it a bit risky to try to hit it, but what you would do is you'd make that first what you would do is make that first smoke cycle, and that saves 5 seconds. Okay, maybe I'll just try the other way doing this. So, as you can see, this maze can be pretty fucking annoying, for lack of a better word. So that would be the quick cycle. Pretend I got the quick cycle. Then you want to hold this direction here, slow your roll a bit. And if you do it right, you'll land perfectly on that. If you want to play it risky. But the way I usually play it is I'll let go of momentum here, spin like this, and go like so. Then you want to slow down around this corner. You want to stop completely right here, hold left until about here, hold upright. And if you do it right, you'll do a little skip in the maze. Of course I'm not doing it right. Okay, ready? So like so. And there we go. Nice little out of bounds there. You get on this, don't fall off. It's pretty important here that you hold back, so that way you get max momentum and you can get off of that a bit early. I messed it up. What you want to do here is go up here once, go up here twice, and then when you get to the height of your jump, hold left or right depending on the side you are. So ready, I'm holding left, and then I get up here again, I'm holding left. Then you get max momentum and you hold up left here. You know, turn with the walls and all that stuff. This is the last ball course in the game. What you want to do here is get a good cycle and go straight past like that. Want to wait for these so you don't fall, and then hold up right, or up left rather. And that's the last ball maze. So I usually go about here and do this movement here, and then just go to like where this havoc seal is, press space. This maze is a bit harder than the other ones, but the other one. But all you have to do is just follow my exact movement, and it's really easy. I used to lose runs like this to crazy. But all you're doing is this simple movement. And none of the ants will ever hit you. Pretty easy, right? And we're done with the hardest maze in the game. Essentially. You don't have to worry about the rocks falling on you ever, as long as you hold the direction you're heading towards. Sorry, there's not much to talk about here. We are about to go into the hive.
We did it! Let's get out of here!
So,
I thought we were goners. I'm gonna get an ice cream.
Right, F. F. And we're in the hive. What you want to do here is get press Q, get your drill gobs out, and you want to drill and go under right about here. You want to go up here, hold up right, and jerk your camera a bit. This skips the 40-second cutscene. So now, you press space again here, you press up, down, up, up, space. Skip that cutscene, wait like a second-ish. You want to double save again. Continue playing now, reload your file. And if you did this 100% correctly, you'll get a thing that says, haha, done and also complete. If you don't get that text dialogue, that means you're softlocked and you have to restart your run. But it's extremely hard to fail. I've never failed it once.
You won't be able to get in there. I mean, you don't have the proper security clearance.
Right.
Look, I like
you. So what we're doing next is called Hive Skip. Now I'm gonna help you. The most broken... This is the most broken area in the run.
Scattered inside the hive.
Although, yeah, it's the most broken area in the run.
I'll give you a key to the throne room.
Won't you get in trouble?
Let's just say I'm planning on moving on.
So you can do this a few different ways. The way that I prefer the most is to do what I'm about to do. So again, you just want to drill into this. And then target here and just do your normal movement tech. And now just do like I do. You want to get to about here and fall off like that. And you just made it down to the second level. So, what you want to do here is, if you want to play it safe, in case you feel like you might mess it up, is go here and just, whoops, go here and just save. But if you don't do that, you just want to go like this right away, grab this ledge and hold upright, or up left rather, fall down, hold up left, hold straight. And you're in the boss cutscene. That's the hive. So this boss, as far as I can tell, it's RNG on PC. It can go anywhere from 2 to I don't know how many cycles. I honestly don't know how this boss works, but what I try to do is just hit him as much as possible with this laser that the queen is firing. And that's about all I can really tell you for this boss. This section of the boss. So I'm sorry about that. See, so if this was GameCube, he'd be dead right there, and we would be beating the fight. But he's not, for whatever reason. So whatever. Ow. Sorry, there's not much to talk about here. I guess one thing to note here is if you get these bugs right here, they give you health if you feel like you're gonna die. Right after you kill this guy, you're gonna wanna switch to your charge ball gun. You should be dead soon. Space, smash space, turn your camera around, press Q, and you want to target these. And if you do it right, that's the fight. Smash space. Switch, press tab, do your quick equip, line up here and do your movement. Once you get about here, turn around, press F, turn around, go back to your normal movement. And if you're doing a PC only trick, PC only emphasis, actually what I need to hear is this, to be like that. So right now, you just need to get your scanner out for the PC only trick if you want to do it. if you don't do it, it's not really that big of a deal. It's basically a one-shot trick that will save 42 seconds. You get one shot to do it. Just kill these guys like so. So, okay, doing my best to explain this. You want to get your scanner out and head to here. And what I do is, from here I tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times. Target. Then you want to scan it. The frame that this menu comes up, you want to press escape and forward. This will bring you into the cutscene with the save menu up. Only works on PC. And then you can save and exit the game. And that will skip the cutscene, so let's try it. I fucked up. So I missed it, and that's it. Simple as that. I'm not gonna bother trying to get it for like 10 minutes. But just know if you bring up the menu, you would... So, I'll just demonstrate this quick. Your menu would look like this, and it would be up while the text is rolling, and the save option would be enabled. You would not be able to scroll with W, S, A, or D. You'd have to scroll with the arrow keys, and you couldn't press space, you'd have to press enter, so it'd be, you know, up with the up arrow, up, up, enter, save, save, quit, load your game back up. And that's a 42 second time save. So there's no sense in not going for it. If you're on PC.
For his excellence, the Emperor.
Pay no attention to that. You will cower before my awesome power.
You know, we should really talk this out face to face.
So what we're gonna do here
in a few minutes.
After this, we're gonna be getting on top of a block and spamming F right away. So ready, F. And if you have a good angle, this will happen. You want to switch to your disassembler and press Q here, hold forward to jump, or that can happen. That's cool too, I guess. Just wait until this falls down if you make that mistake. A mistake I've never made in a run. But that's the first time for everything. Then you want to target movement here. Press space to slide, wait until this is done. And move along. You want to wait, otherwise you'll get knocked off, and then you can just hold right for this duration of this. Press Q here. Once you get off the wall, hold right, click, or whatever your disassembler button is, disassemble that. And I actually got a nice damage boost from that guy, never gotten that before. So I'm gonna save here. There are two different routes you can go. One saves, I'm gonna say, 20 seconds, another one saves, and the other one's the intended route. So, if you want to do the one that saves time, you'll go about here, right? Press Q, tap. Once you get stuck, rotate to about here, and then you will go over. So, this trick is hard, honestly, just because it's frame perfect like every other vault redirect. So, that's why I'm struggling. So, tap. When he gets stuck like that, you want to go to the third one right here, or so, and just try to go over. I would not recommend doing this unless you have a good time, which would be like a 102. Because, as you can see, I've already wasted a ton of time doing it. This is my least consistent trick in the run, other than the menu storage trick, because I don't use either of those tricks in the run. So, that's why this is taking me a while. I want to get it at least once, though. So that's going to be my goal here. So, just again, until you get stuck, camera, and if you go right at the right time and not suck, you will get the redirect. Sorry this is taking so long. The rest of the run has been pretty good, with the exception of this, so cut me some slack. I'll get it eventually. So I was late on my press there. Late on my press, didn't press. Early, late, late. So let's say you jump and you see that the menu disappears. Like if you see the menu go like this and you get the vault, that means you were 1 frame off for every single redirect vault. Don't think I've mentioned that in the run yet. So, everybody who's here, just a little juicy tidbit of knowledge. This sucks. So, I will be showing off the alternative strategy in a second, once I get this. Apparently I was just not meant to get this trick. I'm not sure why that one didn't work. I think I was frame off on that last one. Really, I just should not have mentioned this trick, apparently. Whatever. I guess also to note, you can go over this section as well. Might be easier for you. And if you go over this section and do it correctly, you can, once I set it up, I'll explain it more. You can do that, which is pretty cool. So again, you can do this trick from either side. This is personally the easier side for me. Okay, this is just frustrating me, so I'm just gonna show off the other way to do the room. Pretend like that shit didn't happen. So, what you wanna do is disassemble this. And you wanna raise him up here. And you want this to be on your F. But you wanna right-click him here. Right-click him, shoot him up there, and if you shoot him right, which I didn't, of course, so I'm just gonna try this one more time. This room is my least favorite in the game, so sorry if I don't sound that enthusiastic. You wanna shoot, right click, and if you do that right, both of those will explode and you'll open the door right away. Which I can't do consistently. I need to find a setup for that. There we go. That's how you do that. Copy that. Saves time. Then you just want to target like normal. You want to press Q here. So this is a minute long cutscene skip, so you want to drill down here and just hold forward until you get to past the seal. Then you want to get your lev gun out. Roll along here, get this. We're doing an object redirect again. So what you want to do is push this to this wall now. You want to push it to where this line is. Q, you know, the normal shenanigans. Space on top of that. And that skips puzzle. Or you, if you don't suck like me, you'll be able to do that. And you want to equip your Havoc gloves. And I missed the jump, which is whatever. So I just have to wait for that to fall. So patience is pretty key. Otherwise, you lose a lot of time. A lot of time you don't really need to lose. Jump once that stops rising. Set up here, do your movement. Disengage. Wait until that goes back to normal. And then you want to do this. Press Q at some point in time before you target. This is the last glitch in the run. This is going to be a climb redirect. What we want to do is get our block right about here and drag it up the ramp. And it's very, and you have to do this the exact way I do it, or the trick will not work, because you won't be able to climb the block, and you'll have to do an object redirect version of this trick, which is inconsistent. So I was too far down there, I think, which is why that block fell. So I just have to do that again. It's not really a big deal. So, slide. Then we want to drag this bad boy up here. Get this as close as possible to the wall. And then you want to climb redirect. Simple as that. Face your camera where you face it, and that will happen. That skips this room. The next room is the bottomless pit. This is pretty simple. All you do is lev gun, charge ball, lev gun, charge ball, charge ball. The enemies, they're dead. Get them to explode into you. Then you're in the final room. So target, lev, miss the lev. just kind of hold forward here until you vault. Then you want to do your movement. Last cutscene of the run. Now the strat is slightly finicky. You want to switch to your gun in this room. So left, right, like so. You want to get this guy's attention, let him do his thing. I did not mean to do that. And you just want to keep as much pressure as possible on them, or they won't damage this door, which is what just happened. So basically I just messed up the strat and lost like 10 seconds. You want to knock these guys down with your Havoc Glow of Blast. I think the best way to do this though, instead of just constantly blasting them, is to kind of line them up like so. Make sure you have a good angle on them. And then do that, and they'll damage the door for you. And if you hold straight like this, you'll vault over this and save a second or two. And by a second or two, I mean not that long. So again, you just follow these guys down. I actually intentionally took damage there. So that I'd have full health for this guy, because if you die to this boss, you have to start from the beginning. So the main strat here is just to do as I do. So, ready, lev gun, and smash. Go to these chains. And repeat this, what, 2, 4, 6, 7 more times? Pretty cut and dry boss. I will say though, every third hit, you cannot avoid it unless you grab this ledge. So, when he slams down his fists like this, you have to go like down here, or he will hit you and kill you, and you will have to start the boss fight all over again and lose your run. It's pretty avoidable though. Also, every time you use the Havoc Gloves and you're going to the chain, I would just switch to your Lev Gun to save some time. Avoid these rocks, pretty easy. You can see their shadows, not their sonics. So you switch to the Lev Gun here. And get here. Pretty cut and dry. And then just chill here. Target, blah blah blah. Do that. So, on the last hit of this boss, you're actually gonna wanna press tab and do another quick series of equips. You want to put your charge glove on right click or left click, and your disassembler on right click. That's important for the final boss, which is coming up after this. Again, shadows. I think you get the drill by now. Just 4 more hits. So your split for this should be, if you do the splits the way I do, it should take you 3 minutes and 47 seconds. I split as soon as I get the, well, split doesn't really matter, but I split as soon as I end the final room. So every third hit, no matter what you do, you will do this, as far as I know. Unless you can manipulate the AI somehow that I haven't figured out, which is possible. The final boss strat is very specific. So I'd play that at half speed. Can you? Thank you. I'm not really sure what I was walking onto there. Doesn't really matter either. And the fight is over. All you gotta do is that, into that, and then left click, right click. And you can die here to BM him. And now we're heading to the final boss. You want to target about, not here, but target here, I guess. No, this is where you want to target, like this. To move, turn around, go against this wall, target, hold back, target, and spam right click, and this is the final boss. What you want to do here is let him fire at you, then go exactly here, lock on, lock on, lock on, lock on, hit all four of those. You want to grab this. You want to go like this. You want to target these guys. Get that. You want to come back to the centerpiece right here. And if you did it right, unlike me, so if you mess that up, just repeat the process. I tried something new there, actually. And don't do the fast movement there, do the slow movement, and it will be fine. So there you go. Then right click and move around to avoid his shots. Wait for him to shoot, target that, target, don't get hit, all that shit. I've never seen him go to this side before, so that's interesting, I suppose. And that's the boss, that's the run. Time ends on the final hit. So I hope you guys found this helpful. And be sure to join the Meet the Robinsons Discord if you have any more questions.